The Deebot Neo is said to be ECOVAC's most powerful yet cost-effective robot vac. Available $799 at major retailers, it's certainly compact, but is it smart and powerful? We put it to the test. The Deebot Neo offers four different vacuum modes: Quiet, Standard, Max, and Max Plus. We tested three vacuum modes on both carpet and vinyl flooring, covering an area of our office with cornflakes, sugar, and dog hair. In standard mode, we had to run the vacuum twice for sugar, once for cornflakes and hair, but a few balls of hair flew outside the restricted test area. The max mode handled the cornflakes well, with just one or two flakes left over, and more sugar has been picked up this time around, but we're seeing more pet hair flying outside the test area. The Max Plus mode handled these challenges pretty similarly to the Max mode, but completed them at a faster rate. But again, even more pet hair flew outside the test area. When it came to vinyl flooring, the cornflakes were being pushed around a lot more than in comparison to on the carpet. Sugar performed better on the vinyl flooring, but there were still some leftovers requiring a second go. We just couldn't continue testing the pet hair as the vents had been pushing the hair outside the testing area. Both modes were visibly on a par in terms of performance though. Again, we see movements with the flakes in the test area and sugar has worked much better. Vacuuming pet hair is tricky, especially on vinyl flooring. The higher the suction on the Deebot Neo, the more air pressure that gets released from the vents, which then pushes the hair further away. This is what's left over on most settings. Here are some tips. Avoid vacuuming pet hair on high settings or simply pick up the biggest balls of hair. Limit the use of virtual boundaries so the vacuum can reach the hair that's being blown away on later passes. Max and Max Plus modes perform better than the standard mode on carpets. And the Deebot Neo performed consistently on sugar across all three modes. On vinyl flooring, Max Plus mode did not perform as well as standard Max. This could be the results of the cornflakes being pushed around more by the powerful air vents. When it came to vinyl flooring, the Deebot Neo performed better on sugar than it did on cornflakes on the stronger settings. During the testing, we found that bits of food get trapped underneath the vacuum surrounds and especially underneath the docking station. Overall, the Deebot Neo is great for day-to-day cleaning for the time-starved, even when its impressive suction power can sometimes be a hindrance. That's why tailoring the modes and runtime is essential if you want to do spot cleans. The Deebot Neo offers four mopping modes: low, medium, high, and ultra high. The different modes determine how much water gets released from the tank onto the mop pads. We gave low and ultra high functions a go using the disposable mop pads by spilling soft drink, yogurt, and tomato sauce on vinyl flooring. We were pretty surprised that the low mode seemed to handle these challenges with no trouble at all. Ultra high mode, of course, also handled them with no trouble. We found a few tiny spots of tomato sauce on the test floor from where we'd splattered it, and the docking station does now smell like tomato sauce and yogurt. But we realized that the smell was coming from the test liquids being accumulated in the vacuum's main brush and driving wheels. When comparing the mop pads, low water flow mode has picked up more tomato sauce than ultra high mode, whereas the ultra high mode performed better with yogurt. It's important to note that the liquid accumulated in the main brush and wheels has not been factored into these results. So here are a couple of tips. If you use paper towels for major spills to start with, then use the mopping feature, it's great for general cleaning. Running it twice will also ensure a thorough mop. Don't use the Deebot Neo if you want to disinfect your floors with some kind of liquid detergent, because only tap water is allowed to be used in the tank. Overall, the Deebot Neo is great for general cleaning, but just not for spills of the thicker consistency. So far, the Deebot Neo is looking smarter than a fifth grader. We tested out some of its notable smart features. Its stair safety technology works like a charm in our filthy office stairwell. It definitely deserves a clean, but it's not working quite as well as expected when it comes to these long pile carpets. The vacuum freezes and prompted us to clean its anti-drop sensors. That being said, its clip detection worked perfectly and prevented it from falling. If for some reason you have long pile carpets on your stairs, maybe set a virtual boundary just before the cliff edge to prevent the vacuum sensor from tripping out. We also tested the anti-collision feature. The vacuum was quick to map out the area in its initial scan and navigated very effectively around obstacles. Speaking of floor mapping, this vacuum has the ability to detect objects as small as 10 centimeters from a distance of up to 10 meters. It can scan and store multiple maps of different floors for customized cleaning, and the app lets you monitor and schedule the clean. We tested its virtual boundary function and it works. It's a useful function to restrict the bot from entering specific areas if privacy is needed. For example, the bathroom. It does get a little lost and break the boundaries if you do not return the DeeBot Neo properly to its docking station though after lifting it off the floor. You've got to align the bot precisely to its charging plates. That's why we'd highly recommend you avoid picking it up and let it find its own way back home. One of the selling points of the DeeBot Neo is its dual cleaning function. This two-in-one bot can both vacuum and mop hard floors at the same time. You're able to customize setting for suction power, water flow and cleaning sequences for each room. It'll keep you in the loop and tell you what it's doing in real time. The DeeBot Neo will instantly detect and react to carpet, then chooses to boost the power to max plus mode for a deeper clean. When the mopping plate's installed, the DeeBot Neo automatically turns on mopping mode. It's also smart enough to know when its services aren't needed. It uses sensors to automatically switch off mopping mode if it encounters carpets. This robot back knows when it comes time to recharge. It will automatically return to its docking station when the battery runs low and continue cleaning where it left off as soon as it's fully charged again. That's pretty smart. For $799, the base model comes with a bot, user manual, 10 disposable mopping pads, charging dock, and a mopping plate with a reusable pad. Small dustbins, though, are expected when it comes to robot cleaners in the market. You can purchase a compatible auto-empty station for the DeeBot Neo separately from its manufacturer, ECOVAC. It boasts a large 25-litre disposable dust bag that can hold refuse collected for up to 30 days. Because of the flap within the dustbin, it can take a few goes to empty the bin without dirt falling out from the various openings. Overall, the DeeBot Neo is an absolute unit that features all the smart functions you'd expect. Want to know more about the latest innovations in appliances? Go to canstarblue.com.au/appliances. Thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe to Canstar Blue's YouTube channel.